Hello everybody, Ian Robson here. Welcome back to an episode of Sosnovka. Alright, we got a couple things going on today. We need to get a plow, because I realized that last time I started like cultivating and stuff, but I needed to plow some fields. So now I got 4 fields, and 3 of them need to be plowed now. How much is this field again? 280, that's not too bad. All 3 of them need to be plowed, basically, so we're going to go ahead and pick up a plow. And I'm not going to use one of the in-game plows just because they just take a long time to use. Although it may be very realistic, I just don't like using them. So I have a couple other options here. I have Case True Tandem, another True Tandem. This one's got, I forget what they call those, tines in the back. These guys, which actually are, which wouldn't be too bad actually. This is from the mod hub, if memory serves. Using these ones wouldn't be terrible because what would happen is you'd just be able to drive straightforward base, then you'd probably get the whole field pretty easily. Actually, that might not be a bad idea. This is what I was gonna go for. It's 11 meters, mind you, but you need a super powerful tractor. But this might be a bit quicker, not quicker, but way cheaper, because where's the closest 4 meter plow? So this Lemkin is a 4 meter plow, and this is a 6 meter one. This one here, 6.2. So I think we'll try it out. Let's just lease it for now and see if we like it. It's super cheap to lease and to buy. And this way I don't need to upgrade my tractor either. I was considering upgrading my tractor. There we go, put the music back on. I was considering upgrading this tractor to the 336 horsepower tractor. There we go, jeez. Anyways, but I refrained from doing that, so here we are. So let's give this a go. I think this one you can actually attach stuff to the back of it too. Strangely enough, this is what you can get in the Kuhn DLC. Has the same sort of idea. So you have this and then you have another attachment on the back. So let's just double check. Is it in the cedars? No. But I think there's another variation on this. Maybe a cultivator that goes with this one. Yeah, so I think you can attach these behind that as well, if you want to. So, anyways. So, I wonder if you could, how big is this? You could, let's see here. I wonder if that would work. Let me just check something real quick. Let's check the weeders real quick. There they are. How wide is that? 12 meters? Does it have a 3-point? You might be able to hook this up to the back of this. As weird as that is. I wonder if that'll work. Let's just find out. Could seed with this one, but we don't want to seed. Let's just lease that one as well. Because if we could do that, that means you get a plowing bonus, then you get it fertilized at the same time. You're going slow anyways with the, because you're using a plow here, so you might as well try it. See if you can get with the cedar or the weeder as well. Let's see, is that gonna attach? Oh, that totally does. That's a little OP maybe. It's like 4 meters versus 12 meters. That's pretty funny though. Wonder if that'll work in field work mode. Let's find out. All right, so field work. This is what, 4 meters? Let's see how that would work. 3.9 we'll go for, and then we'll choose, I don't know, doesn't matter which field really, 14, sure. And starting corner, southwest, heading north. Now the problem you may run into is that one is 12 meters, and it may not unfold both of those implements, or it may not unfold the leader, but we're going to find out. Alright, let's see here. See how this would work. Originally I was going to use a big tractor. Let's go first waypoint here. No error. That's good. Now is it going to unfold? Oh, it totally does. That's awesome. Turn on field activated. Yeah. That's interesting though. That it does works with both of those. There you go, so you can have that. It looks a little silly to have the Look, plow and then pulling behind the seat, the weeder, but just gives you an idea that you can theoretically have that. So that should be fertilized twice, I guess, then. Let's take that off. I can't tell, it's too small. Looks like it is, though. But there you go, that works together. So now all I need to do is, after that, you just can straight up seed, basically, after that, and you're good to go. That's funny, though. So you could hook up a cultivator behind that as well, but... yeah, that's pretty funny, actually. So now, basically, what's going on is, basically, it's only... because I set it to 4 meters wide, it's basically working off the little plow there. And you really don't need something this powerful for that little guy. I don't even know what the horsepower is requirement for that. Probably like less than 100. Well, maybe not. It's 4 meters, so... at least. Now, wow, 200? Okay, maybe it's higher than I thought it was. But basically, what this is doing is, any place you may have missed for fertilization, you're going to catch it. And you're also going to get a... well, that's pretty neat. That tracker's still overkill for that particular procedure, but... you can hook things up behind that. Like, that particular implement is made to work with these cultivators. So you can get a plow and a cultivator back-to-back. So, like, these guys right here. So you can hook these ones behind them. And that's the same thing that's going to happen in the Coon DLC when that comes out, which is going to be today at some point, so... all right. I wonder if there's any other fertilizers here. I don't think... that's 12, so it'd be the same thing. The difference here is I'm not paying for fertilizer by using that. That's why it's a little OP, perhaps. Whatever. It's all good. Anyway, so we have $200,000. I think I might stick with that for the time being. It's slow, but you get a good bonus there, so. And what that might allow us to do is, let's just double check. Where's the BGA here? Right over here. Do I have that installed? I should do. Yes, 240 for the startup. So we need 40 grand still. I think I can make 40 grand happen. Let's see. No, we could sell some canola. Let's grab. Where's the other Deutz? Here it is. I think we can make 40 grand happen. I could progress time, actually, and then mow some more. Honestly, that'd probably be the cheapest, the easiest way to do that. Let's grab this trailer over here. I don't know why I keep putting them over here. This is just out of my way, I guess, which is why I keep them over here. I think I'm kind of want to fire up the BGA a little bit. Either that or get more cows. One of the two. I can't do both. Well, this is a long run away from... maybe I should buy a field closer to the BGA first, though. Might be an idea. Actually, how far is that? It's not... because we have a giant grass field. That's why I'm kind of like hemming and hawing. Alright. 11, 12. Vegetable warehouse? Sure. Sell veg. Canola. There we go. So yeah, what you can do is, if I fire up the BGA, I can make a decent amount of money. I think I might need a bigger farm for that still. I think, how big was the other field? Or how much was the other field, I should say? This one down here. 28. I think it was 280? Yeah. 280. Apparently I have no reputation with this guy at all. So I could decrease that, of course, by doing some combining. Technically, maybe not right now, but that's a possibility. So then you'll have all three of these are like the biggest fields anyways, pretty much, or some of the biggest fields. But we have 23, and I don't know, and it's not that long to the biogas plant over there. It's not that far. It's tempting. Or my other option might be to decrease the size of the BGA. So if you're asking what the heck is this mod I'm looking at, why I have to buy the BGA, it's because I have the BGA extension in. That's what allows me to kind of have this weird scenario set up. All right. All right, 240,000. So you can decrease or increase the size of the plant. So I can make it So it's a 79%. And you can make it to a very large VGA, and it's super expensive. You can see the price required for the startup going up. So this is, I think 300% is the highest, yeah. So it's 1.1 million to have a VGA that large, which we're not gonna do. 100% is pretty good though. You can make some decent money from that. Yeah, let's do that. We may have to increase some of our capacity for some stuff, but that's okay. I don't do much VGA stuff. But it will allow us to do a few random assortment of things. This field used to be plowed as well, actually, which is kind of funny. I cultivated it and then realized I needed to plow it. I could actually fertilize it now that I'm thinking about it. I don't think I did that yet. Let's go do that right now, then. So that one got put slur on it last time, if you remember. And we just didn't get a chance to fertilize it yet. So after we cultivated, I never put fertilizer on it. So what I can do here is I can bring that setup over here and have it work away here. Actually, it's going to be the problem with that setup is because the weeder is so wide that the problem we run into actually is maneuvering around some of the areas where the trees are close to the edge. Maybe 34,000 from that. It's not so bad. Not quite enough for the BGA though. Close, but no cigars, the expression. Should we look into what the maintenance costs are for some of my vehicles are right now? This one's at 77 hours, and the other one I think is at 80-something hours. Which is a bit on the high side. Could get the repair mod, I suppose. It's an option. So far it hasn't been a problem yet. There we go. So basically, the step I'm doing right now is being done over there already. So I can just seed right into that right now without a problem because of the weeder. But I didn't think that was going to work out. Technically, what I could have done, which might have... What if you can use the bigger... I guess it doesn't make a difference, really. I don't know if that would make a difference or not. I wonder. It's using the other seeder. It's a bit smaller, but doesn't have any seed in it. So, of course, we might be like, hey, there's no seed in this thing. It's not going to work. So I don't know. That will be curious. There we are. Close that up. That's ready to be plowed now, basically. I did it in a totally wrong order, but that's fine. Yeah, they'll survive. I think 25 needs to be fertilized still. Turn that off. Yeah, it does. Okay, let's do that real quick then, too. Didn't have enough slurry. We actually ran out of slurry last episode on this field 23 here. So I never got a chance to do the whole field, basically. So unfortunate, but that's the way it goes. All right. Game, set, match. So we're going to fertilize this field. I think maybe I'll hire a worker for that. And we could just progress time, that could work too. 25. Fertilize. We want it at first waypoint. It's right in front of us, that's pretty slick actually. You're not offset, are you? Good, no. Thought that guy was offset for a second. That's fine, continue. Just sell the rest of that canola, might as well. And that'll give us enough money for next time. And then what we can do is we can get set up for some silage action. This is a long, that's not that far. With this tractor might be a bit of a long, might be a bit long, but it'll get the job done still. This is where the vegetable warehouses way over here. I do like this little bridge. It looks, seems ridiculous, but it's there, so it's kind of funny. All right, one sec, water break. I've already had my two coffees for the day, so I shan't have any more than that. So we have the leveler, we have this, we basically just need to rent a forge wagon basically, and then we'll be good to go. Or a forge wagon, a forage harvester. Because what we can do is, on this field right here, we have grass. If we just windrow it up and then use a chopper and then make haylage out of it, put it in the bunker over there. Can I do that? Yeah, you should be able to. Yeah, because we don't have the far silo extension. The far silo extension was the one where you couldn't put grass in your bunker. Alright, sweet. It's gonna take a while, as you can see. But we are getting it all fertilized at the same time, so I guess it's two steps in one, but it is a bit slower. But the one thing I was curious about is whether it would be able to unfold, and it seems to recognize both implements, which is the crazy part about this. And as you can see, it's not missing much just because of the way this plow is designed. It's like a straight plow. And we set it up for, what is it? Not 12, but I think it was 3.9 meters. So see how it's getting right to the end there? So that's just due to the fact that just the way the plow is designed. And we totally missed this little part up here, but that's fine. So yeah, I can see this right now, basically. So, but I need that tractor to see to go figure. I'll switch out to the other one in a second here. So this is the field that might take a little bit of time with that particular setup. And that's why I was looking at a larger tractor. All right, there we go, 250,000, sweet. So we can fire up the BGA. But, so we have the possibility of doing that now, okay. The AgroStar is slipping. Why are you slipping? Oh, that turn. No, no, he's got it. I remember recording that course and I didn't. It's because of the weight on the front, which is a funny thing about that. It's just a little bit too long, but otherwise it's okay. Okay, so good. Excellent, sweet. Get ready to fire up the BGA, because we basically just, how much would it cost to rent a forage harvester, the Rosselmash? Rosselmash would be 30 to 20,000. That's not too bad. 30,000 or 20,000 plus the header, and then rent that and then set it up. Well, it's not terrible, I guess. Eventually we'll need to buy it. I don't know what would be better in this situation. Do we have anything else we could sell? A little tiny bit of soybeans. Not really. It's not really worth selling anything else at the moment. So, always an option. I suppose, in reality, what I should do is cycle through another hay silage bale cycle. And that would be the best thing to do, honestly. Because once you get that done, it should be fine. Because, for the BGA, we'll have more than enough money after we do that. That'll be like another 200,000. At that rate, I could probably almost buy the forage harvester as opposed to rent it. I do love the way this thing sounds. It's one of the cooler sounding tractors around. Sweet. 4.3 hours on this one. It's not too bad. Not too bad at all. All right, let's park this up over here. Because we don't need it at the moment. This is how I've been parking these things. Just driving up on the hill and then turning back down. Another reason I'm doing this is because it's, I guess this one I didn't really need to do it, but that's how I've been doing it. Probably not the legitimate, not the way you'd probably used to seeing it, but the way it's being done. Alright, no one's coming. Good. Yeah, it might make more sense to cycle through another grass series before I get all crazy with the BGA. Having a little bit of extra money with the BGA, it's kind of like with the BGA extension, you just need to be a bit more prepared, basically. And that is the big part of it. Because you need to feed it every 8 a.m. and 8 p.m. And you can make some decent money from it. You make about $30,000, $40,000 a day. It's also on top of your cows. So let's just double check to see how much we actually made on the cows, just out of curiosity. That's how much we made from sold bales the other day. Sold milk, 14,000. That's not too bad. So, anyways, I think I'll end the episode there. I'll do a couple things off camera. They'll come back next episode, and hopefully we'll be ready to do some silage. So, that's it for me for today, folks. My name's Ian Robson. I hope you enjoyed. If you did, why don't you go ahead and hit that subscribe button for some more Farm Sim action. Catch you guys later.